Hello and welcome to the Compulsory Action List tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to be talking about compulsory action lists. So the idea behind this is that when your engineers go on site, they will have to do an action list before they can edit or do anything on the job. And this will make it compulsory. This could be good for some compliance reasons, but also it can be good to make sure those action lists are done before the job commences. Okay, so let's begin. So what we're going to do is we're going to go up to settings. We're going to go to settings again, and we're going to click on action lists. And in here will be all your action lists. Now, if you don't know how to create action lists, then there is another article on how to create action lists, and you can go to that after this video. Okay, so what we're going to do is you can see that we've got two action lists in here, and there's two new columns, one called compulsory and one called compulsory category. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to tick this vehicle check action list to be compulsory, and we're also going to tick the dynamic risk assessment one to also be compulsory. Once we do that, we can then select a category. Now, we've already created some for you. So one is going to be health and safety check. And we've got another one called also risk assessment as well. Now, you can add to these by going into types, and you'll be able to see compulsory action list type. You can click on the little arrow, right click on compulsory action list type, click on new sub item, and you can add another one. So let's just go back to action list, and then we can see we've got those action lists in there. So asking us to save it, that's fine. We're going to press OK now, and then we're going to see what it looks like in a job. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to jobs, we're going to go to new, but I am going to click on new job from template. So I want to do it from a template just to show you the action list action from here. So we've got a call out, and I've got my action list, and you can see that these action lists have already been put in here. But you'll also notice this little tick box that says compulsory lists must be completed in order in Clik Remote. So it must be in this order. Now, if you want to change that order, you can click on these arrows up and down, and that will change the order. Okay, so let's just create a job. I'm going to put in a customer. And then I'm just going to assign my engineer to this job. So you click on engineers, add, find my engineer, and assign him. Now, what you can also do here, obviously, you can go to action list and you can make sure that that's all ticked. You'll notice this is grayed out. Compulsory list must be completed in order in Clik Remote. So now I'm going to save and close this job. And now I'm going to open up my Clik Remote. So I'm in my Clik Remote. I'm just going to refresh to get that new job. So I'm going to go to my job number 38. It's got the categories that they're in, and it's also got what the action lists are. So I'm going to click on edit next to vehicle check. I'm going to answer the question, and then it might ask me for some comments as well, or a tick box. I can just tick that, click on close, and that's done. So that's one action list done. But now I can open up the dynamic risk assessment. I can click on edit. I can answer the question for that one. Click close. And now you'll see the edit function is now open. I can now also add my ties, my materials and documents, and even go to other action lists that might not be compulsory as well. Okay, that's it for compulsory action lists. Thank you very much for listening.